Hey everybody, hope you're all doing well. My name is Steven, and this is the Storytime Channel. Today we've got some malicious compliance stories, and our first story of the day is by I'm Here, I Know Right? I guess my new boss is messing with the wrong single mother. A little background, I just gave birth a few months ago. During my maternity leave, I was requested to join in a Zoom meeting. They said it's very important, so I obliged. I love my company so much since it always had my back when I got pregnant. Ahem, single mom. And got sick on my sixth month. Meeting was about me being transferred to a new boss due to realignment. This new boss then started calling me and asking me to do stuff which actually could wait until I get back from my maternity leave, because of course the company knows I'm on leave. She always says there's a deadline for some online learning and stuff. She also asks me to attend some meetings, company annual online parties, which she said is mandatory to attend to, and most of my office mates will ask me why I'm attending since I'm on leave. Well, I'm the kind of person who doesn't really complain much. If I can do it, I just do it. Talking back or talking ill against somebody is a waste of my energy. Everything is remote anyways, and my baby is sleeping almost all the time and camera is off, so I can breastfeed. Now fast forward to this week. It's been 3 weeks since I'm officially back to work. Still work at home setup, and I know bosses have different leadership styles, but I'm afraid I can say she's kind of a pain in the butt. She demands things to be done ASAP when these are the ones which should really take a little time to get the best results. She will talk in the sweetest voice and tone, but her message is basically telling you to freaking finish this now. Just imagine an evil character in a movie smiling at you, but the eyes are scary while telling you that she's about to kill you. I then found out from my old boss that this one is full of pride and always wants to be the best. Never asks for help from anyone, and wants to impress the big boss all the time. 2 days ago, I messaged her sincerely apologizing that I have to file a leave the following day because my baby is set to do vaccines. I said I was sorry because in my calendar, it's a week from now, and planning to file a leave this weekend. But the doc secretary just called and it has to be the next day. And in my country, I have the solo parent ID, so leaves like these are really valid. She called me up and asked me how many hours it should take. I said it's gonna be in the morning, but I really want to file a leave because most of the time, babies get fever after. And of course I want to take care of my baby. She said since we are just working from home, I don't need to file a leave and just adjust my working hours. I wanted to explain that I really want to take the entire day off and not work at all, especially at night because I want to observe my baby. But she literally ignored me and did not let me talk and just said her goodbyes and hung up. Imagine my surprise when around 9 a.m, the MF messaged me to join the conference call for our meeting. Cue malicious compliance. I said I'm on my way to the clinic and will just join once settled. I just ride the tuk-tuk to the health center, so I can't join just yet because I'm holding my baby securely. I graciously obliged to join the conference call while a lot of other babies are crying. Vaccination schedules are the same day, so maybe half of the town's babies are there and they are all my accomplice. I press mute, of course, but when it's my turn to speak, I speak super close to the microphone while other babies were either shouting due to the injections, crying just because they're bored, or maybe laughing at my boss right now. My own baby is just so quiet looking, like the cutest MF latching on me. I can hear in my boss's voice the regret of not allowing me this day off, but she can't do anything about it now. I'm on the meeting answering all her questions and impressing everyone in my team like a boss. I can imagine their faces when they have to lower the volume when it's my turn to speak. I then sent her a message regarding the next vaccination schedule and that I want to ask permission to file for a leave that day. Well, of course, she said yes. If you found yourself in OP's shoes and you were in that medical center and all those babies were crying, would you go full open microphone in that meeting and let them enjoy the full brunt of all the babies crying? Just to give them a little extra something to regret making you work? Let me know in the comments down below. Our next story is by Unicorn Space Station. Everything needs to be displayed according to the 5-year-old layout plan you have from our company. Yes, I am sure. Hey, Big Mama is back with one of my oldest malicious compliances from back in the days of me working retail in an electronics store. Background: the store I was working at had deals with suppliers where we not only sold their products, but they were also paying us for a certain space where their products would be displayed. We had the responsibility of restocking it and keeping it in order so it would look nice as stuff were sold out and new were coming in. Roughly once a week, a representative from each brand and supplier would come, make it look extra nice, take a picture for his report, chatted with us for a bit, maybe asked us to change a few things here and there. Most of them were nice and chill people, and we had a good relationship with them. Well, not this new guy whom we shall call Bruce. Bruce was from a company that had rented an entire shelf, think around 8 meters wide, 2 meters tall, in our TV section for every cable you can think of. HDMIs, coax, aux, and many others in various lengths and prices, including some very premium, read needlessly expensive, options. When he came in, it wasn't super tidy since it was in the middle of a busy day, but it was in no way a mess or anything. Just normal, people bought some stuff, so it's not beautifully aligned and one or two things are on the wrong hook. Look, he started chewing up one of my underlings, which I overheard and came over right as I finished with my customer. Hi, is something wrong?
The heck it is! This is not what we agreed upon! It's a mess!
It doesn't look that bad to me, it just needs to be restocked a bit.
No, it's all wrong. Look,
he said, pointing at the layout on his phone.
This doesn't belong here, this doesn't belong here, this should be over there instead of that.
He was yelling while pulling all the stock from the hooks and dropping it on the ground. Okay, stop. Hold on, stop. Let's figure this out. Show me the plan. He handed me his phone, I took a bit to go through it, and realized it was not updated for years, as we did not carry most of the products listed there anymore. This was common as these layouts were more like a guide for us on how things should look like, at least with the other suppliers. See, you no longer send us these ones, or these. We do what we can to make it nice, we want to sell too. And do you see these and these? Those are not listed in here. We needed to put them somewhere, and here, it makes sense since it's next to these cables. Where else should we put them?
All items not listed here go in this miscellaneous bin. Are you new here or something? We send you these layouts for a reason. We expect them to be followed. Is that something you are capable of doing?
Of course. Can you send me the layout via email again, with maybe some exceptions if you want us to go make any? I might have displaced it. I didn't, but I wanted it in writing. He sighs.
Sure, here you go. I don't want to make you guys look bad, so I'm not going to take the photo today, but I need to send my report tomorrow. I will stop by in the morning. Can you fix it by then?
We will get right on that. Sorry about that. He left and I went to my office to check the email. My plot worked perfectly as the email read, please follow attached layout plan, no exceptions. Just to be sure, I called my boss, told him what happened, told him how dumb it is to follow the outdated plan, he knew, but we agreed that that's exactly what he wanted us to do. He approved extra hours for two part-time colleagues and we got to work. First, we fixed what he threw on the ground and made it look nice the way we usually do. Took a picture, and then started on redoing it according to his wishes. The entire process took about 8 to 10 man hours, and in the end, two-thirds of the shelf were bare as baby bottom. The misc bin was overflowing and a complete mess, and we still had to put a few huge boxes of stock back to the warehouse. We took a picture, closed the store, and went home awaiting the upcoming crap show. The next day, both me and my boss had a shift scheduled, and when Bruce arrived, he lost it. My boss politely asked him to deal with it in his office, otherwise he would have him removed from the store. Apparently, he kept blaming us, and in his rage, this dum-dum with a brain so dense that it could only be examined by a geologist decided to storm out of the store and placed a complaint on us to his corporate. Needless to say that my boss explained the story to them really well, forwarded Bruce's email, and attached a picture of before and after that we made the day before. Within 2 hours, Three guys from the company came and started redoing the whole thing pretty much the same way we had it before. We helped when we didn't have any customers to tend to. They promised to draft and send us new updated layouts, but made it clear that we are welcome to adjust it as we see fit based on current stock. We never heard from Bruce again, nor had any issues with this company. What another lovely malicious compliance tale from Big Mama themselves. It definitely does not take a rocket scientist to see this 5-year-old outdated layout plan that features cables that don't even exist in stock anymore and know that you need to adjust to that. Not just shove everything not listed, which is all the basically brand new cables, into a miscellaneous bin. Just imagine you need one of a newer kind of cable, say like a USB-C or something. So you go to this place and you end up seeing nothing but old cables on the shelves, and then all these new, brand new, fancy, higher tech cables in the miscellaneous bin? That alone is enough of a red flag. Our next story is by Gent Potato. Actually, this is exactly what you asked for. To set the scene, I work for a pretty large promotional product manufacturer. We mainly print a lot of products, but this story specifically revolves around scratch and win cards. My first year that I started working at the company, one of the largest distributors in the US asked for a quote on a pretty large scratch and win order. It was just a rough estimate as the total quantity was not set in stone by the end user. It would need to be dropshipped to about 400 different destinations, and the quantities were into the hundreds of thousands, if I remember correctly. There were 10 different cash prize amounts ranging from $5 to $100. Normally, when we receive orders, we receive purchase orders that will show the total quantity of each layout from the company. However, the sales rep that I was dealing with sent me a spreadsheet with all 400-ish locations and how many of each prize layout needed to be drop-shipped there, with no total quantity at all on the spreadsheet. I asked the rep if a proper PO would be sent in, and he asked I consider the spreadsheet a PO to get the order going, which I can do with his authorization, so I proceed. After the proofs are ready, I send them to the rep, along with an order confirmation showing the total cost of the order and the cards that needed to be printed. He approved both the confirmation and proofs, so we pushed them into production and they shipped out the following week. About 2 weeks after everything delivered, I received a phone call from the president of sales of the distributor, who seemed extremely concerned with the order and making claims that we made a massive mistake that we would need to credit them for. I asked him what he believed the issue to be, and he told me that the end user had planned to pay about $750,000 in prize money total. But they had already cashed out about $500,000, with a little over a third of the cards being redeemed, and that we would be responsible for any of the redemption money beyond the $750,000. Me, using the little Excel knowledge I had at the time, used AutoSum to figure out that the spreadsheet they provided me with actually called for a total of almost $2 million in prize money. In the nicest way possible, I told them that the order we received from them asked for a total of around $2 million, and because of that, we could not be held responsible for the excess. This dude absolutely lost his mind telling me that I was wrong and that we messed up and we needed to make things right. Because I was not in the mood to fight with this man, I asked him for his email and forwarded him the email with the spreadsheet we were provided, along with the rep stating that the spreadsheet was how they were providing their order, and even a screenshot of the auto amounts while I was on the phone with him. He started freaking out a little more, said he would give us a call back regarding the matter, but that call never came, and our company never received an email from the rep who provided that order again. That's only a $1.25 million oopsie. No big deal, Excel mistakes happen. You would think if they're putting an order in, handling that amount of money, they would make darn sure that that was right. Somebody definitely lost their job after that. And our final story of the day is by Robo Ninja Pirate, Cheapo Consignment Store. Many years ago, when our first son was a toddler, my wife was shopping in a consignment store for kids' stuff. She happened to see a lady bringing in a bunch of stuff to sell to the store and overheard the conversation. This woman had multiple bags of Thomas the Tank Engine toys and tracks, as well as one of the train tables. If it was new on the shelf, it would be several $100s worth of stuff. The employee working there offered her a lowball offer, saying,
$100 is the most I can offer. If you think you can get more, you are going to have to find a buyer yourself.
My son was a huge Thomas the Tank Engine fan, and my wife's eyes lit up. My bargain hunting wife immediately went over and said, I think you just found a buyer. Will you take $200 for all of it? The employee got mad and said they weren't allowed to conduct business inside the store. So my wife helped her carry it out to the parking lot and gave her $200 for a ridiculous number of Thomas the Tank Engine toys that my son, and eventually his younger three siblings, played with for years. Imagine they were trying to lowball somebody that much so that they themselves could turn around and try and sell it for $300. Trying to get 150 to 200% increase in what you paid for it. That's a pretty scummy place and, at the very least, worthy of a bad review. But with that being said, that's all the time we have for today. So if you have a favorite story of the day, let me know which story and why in the comments down below. But besides that, if you enjoyed the video, please consider giving it a like, and if you haven't, subscribe and turn notifications on so you'll never miss an upcoming video. No matter what you do, whether it's just viewing the video, liking, subscribing, turning notifications on, I appreciate the heck out of it. Every little thing that you do helps the channel grow that much more, and I can't thank you enough for it. So, until next time, I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I'll be right here next time on the Storytime Channel.